So, Scotty, James Harden is on a tear. He's on a scoring surge that we haven't seen before. How would you defend this man? Now, I don't know if you've guarded in your days scores like this that are left-handed. So it's a difference than guarding, you know, guys that you've guarded in your days, the right-handed dominant. This man is left-handed and he's dominant. He can shoot the ball from the perimeter. He can drive the ball. He creates fouls. How would you guard James Harden today?
Well, first of all, you have to start guarding James Harden when he get out of his car going into the arena. Try to limit his touches with the basketball. Make it hard for him to get the ball inbound. Make it hard for James Harden to bring the ball up the basketball court. In doing all this, I'm taking time off the clock.
So what you're saying is when your team scores the basket, you're finding James
Harden.
I'm going
to find
James Harden. You're picking up 94
feet. Yes. Even if he's in a parking lot, I'm coming to find him. I think you have to make James Harden work, and that takes time off the clock. I think he's very comfortable walking into his comfort zone and picking apart the defense.
Brandon,
so if I could take the ball out of his hand, that would be my first line of defense.
So now, the rules are different than when you played, right? So
yes.
James Harden is ISOing. He gets the ball past half court. He's ISOing you. He's doing his thing. Are you going to allow him to get his rhythm by dribbling the ball 20 times? What are you going to do in that when he's ISOing? Are you going to come up?
I will attack his left hand and force him to beat me right. And I will give him not completely direct line to the basket, but almost inviting him to go take a layup.
Now, I'm James Harden, right?
Yes.
You're going to play on my left hand.
Yes.
You know what he likes. You know what he likes to do.
Yes.
I know you're long. You got long reach.
Yes.
But they allow him to travel these days.
I know.
With a double step back.
And I understand. And they allow him to put the contact on the defender.
I don't care how long you are and how much space.
I got a 7-foot wingspan.
I don't care about that because for me to take a double step back, I'm going to create so much space, you're not going to be able to bother my shot.
I will play James Harden from behind. I will be able to bother his shot because I will play him to force him into driving, and I'll just sit on his right shoulder all night. I don't care if he beat me going to the basket. I don't care if he throws lob passes. He's not going to do it with his left hand.
Okay. So everything that you're going to do is
it's going to force him to use his
right hand.
Passing.
I could have a driving lane all night, but you're not going to allow me to get in my rhythm and stand out and shoot threes.
No. And I may pick up a few fouls trying to dictate him and force him to do certain things, but I will make him have to be efficient on driving the basketball.
Now, when he's a mastery at drawing fouls, so as I'm driving the ball and you're on my hip.
I'm chasing. I'm not on your hip. I'm chasing.
You're chasing me from behind into your center.
Yes.
So now you're going to put your center in jeopardy of getting in foul trouble.
Somebody going to be in foul trouble.
Right?
Okay. Well, I don't want to say I'm putting him in. I want them or he or whoever make James Harden make shots. And that's what I think teams
do. That's what he is. He's a shot maker.
Well, he has to make shots.
He's a shot maker. Well, now, he's going to take 30 shots, but he's a shot maker.
I think forcing him to take 30 layups is better than allowing him to take 13 threes as he's shooting.
All right, so I got one for you. Now, this guy's left-handed is putting up crazy numbers. Now, your teammate, MJ.
Yes.
After playing with him for all those years, how would you guard MJ?
I would pretty much play Michael just opposite of what I would do to James Harden. Probably won't give him as much direct line in terms of watching how James Harden play. He tends to want to shoot the three ball more.
Yes.
So I would want to push him into a drive. Whereas Michael was more of
give him some space a little bit, make him take the jumper.
Exactly.
And contest the shot.
I would probably try to square up and play Michael more in front because he could go either way.
So because of you're taller, you're longer than Mike.
Yes.
He would take you out on the perimeter.
Exactly.
Well, did Mike used to post guys up that are taller than him?
No, later on in his career, he did because he had the physical ability to bang and get the space. But early on in his career, he didn't care, be honest. Big, small, he would either go inside or out. Obviously, if it's a bigger guy, he's going to bring him out and beat him off the drive.
All right, so I was a scorer, right?
Yes.
One-on-one, I don't think I could be stopped. I don't give a damn how long, how great you can move, angles, I don't care. Like, you know, if an offensive player has it going one-on-one, it's tough to stop those guys. Do you think there is any defense to stop a guy that's a prolific scorer?
The way that you stop a guy like this is with a team.
Yes.
You don't stop a great scorer. Maybe I should say that. But what you want to do is make every shot very difficult and contain him. And that's what I don't think teams are doing to James Harden, because they're not trying to get the ball out of his hands. And to stop a score takes a lot more energy than it does to stop a team, because you got to fight to get the ball out of James Harden's hand, or he's going to do damage to you in a half-court game.
Well, appreciate it, Scotty. We'll see if any of these teams around the NBA will listen to this man right here. He knows what he's talking about.